attstrpure with a tutorial on how to reflect your video or image clips in Sony Vegas. You don't need Sony Vegas Pro to do this, but it will look slightly different if you don't have it. First off, let's start with one video track, and just get your video or image clip. And I'll delete this audio. Now, give your video or image clip some room to do the reflection effect. That should be good. Now right click your track and select duplicate. This will make another copy of the image or video. Now right click it and select flip vertical. And move the clip so the bottom edges are just touching or a little bit apart. Whatever your preference is. You may want to lower the opacity from around 50 to 70%. That looks pretty good. Now, this is an okay reflection, but we can add more to this. Now, to get the extra reflection effect, we want to blur the bottom edge of the clip a little bit. There are a few ways to do this, and if you don't have Sony Vegas Pro, you'll want to go to your video effects and choose cookie cutter and drag that onto the bottom clip. You'll want to make the shape a rectangle or square and move the clip upwards a bit and put the size up. Now drag the feather slider and you should see the bottom edge of the clip start to blur. You can just mess around with that to get the effect you want. Now if you have Sony Vegas Pro, you can go into the pan and crop interface and select mask. You'll be making a mask around the bottom edge of the clip and try to make the line fairly straight. The rest doesn't matter. Now go to feather type and choose out. And you can raise the feathering a bit to get it however you want. Now this is a pretty good reflection effect. You may want to move your video or image around a bit, but if you go into the pan and crop interface, you'll see that it only moves the top or bottom clip. So to make both of them move the same amount, you'll want to click this Make Composite Child button, and now you can go to your parent motion and drag the clips around so they'll both go at the same time. If you don't want just a black background, you can go to your media generators and choose color gradient and choose one of the colored black drops and put it into a track below. You can also move these colors and change them however you want. So that looks pretty good. And now if you don't have Sony Vegas Pro, this is pretty much all you can do besides moving the clip around more. But if you have Sony Vegas Pro, you can make sure the compositing mode is set to 3D Source Alpha and click the parent motion again. You'll see this interface has changed and you can mess around with the 3D settings. You can just move these around and set it how you want and just make a more interesting effect for your photo or video. And if you play around with this, you can get a pretty good effect. So once you're done, this is what it will look like. I hope this tutorial helped you all, and please subscribe. Thanks for watching.